Genesis 2:18, the Lord God said, "It is not good for man to be alone. I will make a helper suitable for him." And so, you know, I was thinking about this because I've been, you know, pondering, Lord, what did you want me to speak about? And he's like, I want you to talk about relationships. Well, obviously, you two are married, and I'm single, so you guys are going to be able to share more about the marriage, and I'll be able to share about singleness. And actually, singleness is, it's a quality or state of being single. Now, you have to know that when Adam was created, he was created single.
Yes.
And he was created whole. Mm. Right? Mm. So if you think about it, really the intention of God was to create us as whole, as being whole. And not that, you know, we had, you know, to have all this, you know, stuff on us, but he created Adam to be whole. And then he said, well, you know, I don't want Adam just to be talking to the trees and, you know, naming all the animals. He's like, you know, let me, you know, create a woman for him. And so he did. And so I love that it says single. A single person is not in a relationship. A single person is unmarried. And I think that when you realize that you're okay to be single, you know, it's okay to be single in who Amen. God created you to be, then, you know, it's like, okay, let's just say, you know, for example, that, you know, maybe there's a man of God in my life, okay? And I'm praying God's will. You know, I'm praying God's will. Lord, if this is your will, then, you know, let it be. And if it's not, then remove him. And when you have your heart that is like being the bride of Christ, and you can say that because you're okay to be single, right?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Then when you say, Lord, if you need to remove him, then remove him. And you know what? You're going to be okay either way. But when you say that, that's when God brings you the man of God or the woman of God.
Amen. Yes.
So I just, you know, I want to encourage people out there that it's okay to be single. You know, it's okay to be married too. You know, we you know, I think that, you know, I think in the Bible, and I think it was Paul that even said, you know, like if you, you know, have, you know, these things where you, you know, you need to be married, then you be married. If you don't, you know, then just it's better to be single and do God's work, mm-hmm. you know, because there has to be a purpose in your life for all of us.
Right.
You know, even as married couples, yes. you know, in fact, I want you guys to share, you know, the purpose of what God has destined for you and your spouse and for you too. And share, you know, like on, like, how do you feel as being a woman of God? And knowing that, you know, that you're a pastor, or, you know, that you have, you know, this destiny that God has given to you. And, you know, like even being on TV, you know, you and your husband, mm-hmm. you know, this is part of a purpose. It's part of a destiny that God has called you Absolutely. To do, right?
Yes.
You know, being a pastor's wife and even being, you know, the worshiper, you know, what has God called you to do? And you know, like, share with the people how does it feel? And you know, like, what are some of the issues? And then how does God overturn those issues in your life so that you can go into that destination and be that woman of God for your husband? Amen?
Amen. Well, first of all, it starts with waiting for the right husband.
Amen.
Okay, because we can all miss that.
Yes.
Right? So waiting for the one that the Lord has for you, and that's exactly what I did. I waited for about almost 5 years, and I waited for the Lord to bring me my husband. But not only that, but being completely surrendered to what God has. And then I had to realize, because I feel like for what the Lord has called me to do, I have a women's ministry. I love women.
Amen.
As far as for healing, abuse, abortion, sexual abuse. I just know that there's a lot of women in bondage, and I've been in that place of torment and bondage. And now that I'm free, we are called to set the captives free.
Amen.
And my heart is towards the women. Okay, so I know that I have that, but my first calling is to be my husband's helpmate. Mm-hmm.
Amen.
And so he has, my husband has an amazing teaching gift, and the Lord has prophesied over us, you know, that, which is amazing. This is several years ago, but he prophesied that we would be on television, there would be books, movie deals. And I'm like, Lord, how is this going to happen? You know what yes. I mean? And then yes. here we are. But so, yes, I do have this heart for women's ministry, but my first ministry is my husband.
Okay, that's
and
good.
And to be his helpmeet so that he can fulfill his God-given destiny.
Yes.
And in the meantime, the Lord will open up doors for me to minister to women
that's
also.
Right.
So
that is
yeah.
so good because, see, you know, God is, I mean, he's just like, I mean, he thinks of everything, you know,
yes.
before we, you know, before we even are born, you know, I mean, he's, you know, like even now that I am, you know, single and all that, you know, and it's been actually 5 years, they'll be in March, 5 or 6 years, like 2012. So yeah, 6 years now. Mm. But you know, to God be the glory because Amen. See, in that time, it was a washing and a cleansing time for me. You know, I had to look at my inner soul wounds and I had to pull those things out of me, you know, because you can't take all that stuff, all that baggage into a new relationship.
Right.
And definitely God doesn't want my baggage. And he's like, I'm going to get you purified. I'm going to get you cleaned up. I'm going to get you righteous. You know, I'm going to get you holy. I'm going to get you set free, that's you know. Right. And so, you know, during that time, that's what God has done within me. Yes. And, you know, I give him the glory because, you know, it's like such a peaceful time in my life that, you know, I have so much fire for God, you know, and it's like sometimes I cannot contain it because, you know, I just want to go lay hands on everyone. I want to go prophesy to everyone, you know. I just, you know, it's just the God in me, you know, and my life has changed because even when, you know, I was living in the world, you know, I mean, like, I lived in the world. Like, I was giving the world all of my time, like, everything right. I wanted to, you know, it was like, you know, you talk about a party, oh, we're going to have a party, you know, we're going to have, you know, all the alcohol and, you know, and all of that. And you know, I just wanted that. And now, you know, I mean, since returning back to the Lord, I want to give him more, you know.
Yes.
I just want to give him everything, you know, because then I see the goodness, and I'm so grateful and so thankful of what he's done in my life for me, you know. And I just want to do whatever it takes, you know, to be that woman of God, to be humble, you know, to show love and give love to people, to help people, you know. And I have my relationship with God is we're like this. You know, and I have that relationship. I love God. I love Jesus so much, you know, that you know, sometimes, you know, like when I get up in the morning, you know, I'm like, oh, Lord, I love you so much. You know, and I feel the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit will just come upon me. And then, you know, tears start rolling down my face
yes.
because I feel his love for me, you know. And when you feel that love, it's a love that you just, you can't even, like, you can't even really express it because it's so pure. You know, it's so pure. So, dear Desiree, I want you to give, you know, maybe share a little bit of your testimony and how God even, you know, brought you and your husband together and how he's, you know, really helped you out and overcome, you know, a lot of situations and issues, you know, and where you're at today. You know, just go ahead. We have some time. So.
Yeah. Amen. Okay, so our story doesn't start out as, you know, being in church or going to church and meeting, you know, in between the pews. So at the time that I met my husband, I was backslidden. So I grew up in church my whole entire life. So my parents grew up in, you know, brought us up in church. You know, there was four of us girls, and we were brought up in church.
Was
and
it
so
a Christian church?
It was a Christian church,
oh, wow.
Christian home, and so I knew.
Yes.
I knew better, you
yes,
know?
Yes,
so, you know, you get to that age where you're like, okay, I'm 18 now. You don't tell me what to do. I'm going to venture off on my own and do my own thing. So
yes.
there I went. And so, and it wasn't even like I wanted to go into the world. So my parents were going to a ministry, and I was like, well, I don't want to come here. I want to go to this ministry. So I, at the age of 18, I'm like, okay, I'm old enough now, so I'm going to go and be and do my own ministry. You know, I'm going to go to my own church, and you go to your own church. And so that's how it started out, going there. But then I wasn't really grounded, and I wasn't really focused, and so I kind of left the things of God. You know, it kind of just dwindled away, the fire. And so I had my own place. I moved out. I did things. I was doing things on my own. So I thought I was, like, you know, grown, the adult, you know. So at that point, I met my husband through a friend. And so, and it's so funny because I go back to this day, I tell my husband, and we laugh about it now, but I ask God, you know, when you ask God for things, you need to be careful, because he gives you what you ask for, okay? So I was like, I'm going to pray, and I'm going to ask God, like, I want this tough guy, and, you know, like, a gangster, and, you know, and so we pray, and I prayed these things, and I was like, yeah, right, it's not going to happen, okay? So I meet my husband, and I'm like, whoa, you know? He was, like, just out there in the world. He was heavily involved in gangs, drugs, alcohol, the whole bit, you know?
And I want to say this, and he is a big guy, too, okay? He is big, all right?
yeah. So then this is, you know, this is who comes into my life at the time. And so, and I know things, and my parents are still going to church, and so I was kind of like done with the world, you know, and just like, okay, but, you know, we met and stuff. And so I started, the church has functions. So they have like baptisms, or they have stuff at the park, you know. And so a lot of times, and because I know growing up in a Christian home, a lot of times when you try to take people to church, they don't want to go to church. They think the four walls in church, and so they don't want to go. So I started taking him to these events. I'm like, oh, come, it's Father's Day. We're going to spend time at the park, you know, or, oh, let's go to this play, or let's go to this function, you know. So he started coming out, and he was enjoying himself, you know, as big as he is, playing football with all of the guys and stuff. So at the same time while he was there, they were ministering to him, and he didn't even know it. He didn't even know it. So he was getting ministered to, and I knew, you know, I knew. So I just let him be and let it be alone. And so we started coming to church. He started making it to services. So my husband, right now, he loves worship. Like, he's a worshiper. He'll be there. We're going to be there for worship, you know. But back then, he would show up after worship was over, or when the preaching was going to start. He was like, okay, let's get a few, you know, half an hour off, and then I'll make it to church. So he would show up. But how many know that the word is like the best part, right? Amen. So the word will come, and it'll pierce your heart, and it'll come back to you, you know? So a few times he came to church, and so finally one day he just started crying like a baby, and he didn't know why. He's like, what are these tears? Like, what? Why am I crying, you know? And God was just touching him. So Amen. That day he gave his life to the Lord, and I rededicated my
Praise
life.
Praise God. Hallelujah.
And so now we're you know, we're in the ministry, and we serve together. And
so wait a minute. So what you're telling the audience here is that your husband came from a gang. He was a gang banger,
yes.
Right?
Wow.
Yes.
And he was living in the world, and was he, you know, with guns and all that stuff too?
Or? Oh, yeah.
Okay, so guns, drugs, I assume.
He was pretty bad, yeah.
Okay, alcohol. Okay, so you can think, people, that, you know, God can turn around your situation in your life. It does not matter where you're going, what you've done. God loves you
just
the way you are. And he will change you, okay?
That's right.
He will change you as he did her husband. And so we give God the glory. But I want to encourage you. Does not matter where you're coming from, what you've been doing. God loves you, and he wants your heart. He really wants your heart. And so I just, you know, we just want to encourage you. That's the reason why we share testimonies, so that you know that this is real, that this is not just a setup. This is a God intervention thing, okay? And so we're just trying to intervene right now, and the Holy Spirit will do the rest for you. So to God be the glory. Amen.
Yes. So, I mean, like I said, he was like the worst of the worst. And like prophet has said, it doesn't matter what type of background you come from, where you come from. You can be the worst of the worst, or you can even think that there's nothing wrong with you, the best of the best, and have it all, and money and riches. But if you don't have God, you don't have anything. So,
amen.
So that's what we're saying here today. But yeah, so it so happens that we come into the ministry, he gets involved, and so my entire family serves the Lord. Thank God for that.
Praise God.
My children, they serve in the children's ministry, multimedia. So they're all involved in some sort of way, you know. And I just thank God, because I know sometimes growing up in the ministry, you know, those PK kids, and they just rebel, and they just, I'm not coming, and
right.
We have a hard time. But I really thank God that we don't have that with our kids. Like, they're like, is it church? Are we going to church today? And I was like, thank you, Jesus, you know.
Amen.
But, yeah, so that's how we met, and now he's like, he's just amazing. He's just like this. Everybody calls him like this big teddy bear, you know, and he's so loving, and he has a great heart, and all of those things that he did, you know, for the enemy, God turned them around for the
Amen.
Good. And so now he uses them, and God really uses him, you know.
And what's the name of the church that you guys go to, so that, you know, if people ever want to come and, you know, meet you guys, where can they find you guys at?
So they can find us. We fellowship at New Beginning Community Ministries, and it's in the city of Baldwin Park. You can visit our website. It's nbcministry.com. It has all the information on there. We have church services on Sunday, three times on a Sunday, and then a Wednesday worship service. So,
okay.
Yeah, so we're out in Baldwin Park.
That's awesome. What a wonderful testimony that is, you know, And that's, you know, the reason why, you know, God, you know, has TV. You know, that's the reason why we have the media, so that we can encourage people to share their story, you know. And I always want to invite people on, you know, to come to Vision TV, you know, call me up, you know, send me a message, you know, because we want your testimonies. You know, the word of God says that, you know, if you keep quiet, it is a sin. But if you open up your mouth, you're being obedient to the Holy
yes,
Spirit.
Yes.
So I have to encourage all of you, because I know a lot of you have testimonies out there. And, you know, God has given us a platform. I mean, the doors are open, both men and women. The doors are open. And I always invite people on the program. Like tonight, Desiree, she didn't even know she was going to come up here.
Yeah.
But you know what? It's like, you know, one of our guests didn't show up, and she came through. So, you know, God is always on time. I mean,
yes,
no matter
yes,
what,
he is.
He's always on time. So let me go back to, it says in 1 Corinthians 7, 32 to 35, it says, I would like you to be free from concern. An unmarried man is concerned about the Lord's affairs. And how can he please the Lord? But a married man is concerned about the affairs of the world. How can he please his wife? And his interests are divided. So, you know, this is kind of like saying, well, you know, if you're single, you know, you don't have to worry about, you know, being, you know, or living in the world or thinking about your spouse, because, you know, you can go and do God's job and you know, and it's okay. But even if you are married, you know, God, you know, he wants to build up that relationship for both you and your spouse, so that you guys are in unity as one. And so that's what I love, you know, when I see, you know, your guys' marriages, I see love in the marriages. I see, you know, that you guys have been married for quite some time, 16 years?
It'll be 16 years this 16 June.
Years?
Yeah,
that
June 21st.
The Holy Ghost, I'm telling you right now.
Amen.
How many years have you been married?
So this year will be 18 years.
Okay, so
wow.
18.
Yeah.
So
congratulations.
See, that is just amazing. And because, see, the thing is that when you have the Spirit of God with you, you know how the enemy can operate, and so you can pray against it.
Yes.
You know, we are prayer warriors, you know. You know, God made these women prayer warriors, you know, and he gave us so much compassion, you know, and so much love, you know, and we are, what's the word I want to say, nurturers. Mm-hmm. We are nurturers, you know, and that's just, in the natural and in the supernatural, we are nurturers. And so when we see a child fall, you know, or, you know, they scrape their knee, you know, all of
right.
the parents run over there, are you okay, you know? And so we want to hold them. We don't want anything to happen to them. And so that's the reason why, you know, I believe that God made us these special women, because, you know, we have that in our hearts, you know, like, no matter what, no one's going to hurt my kid, you know, especially the enemy, you know. And so I love that we can do things for God together. You know, I can do things for myself. You know, I realize that by being single, that is giving me an opportunity to even come to the TV station in the evenings, where sometimes, you know, married couples, they can't because they have a family. And so, I mean, my children are of age, you know, I mean, they're like in their 20s. So, I'm free, and I'm loving my life right now. And, you know, because I get to experience the glory of God, you know, and being around the anointing, and this is like an anointed place, yes. You know, so it's like, I can't wait to come here. It's really, truly an amazing deal for me, because, you know, it's I also get to, you know, give my talents away. And what I mean by that, by giving my talents, is I get to pray for people. You know, I get to speak life into people. You know, I can share testimonies. You know, I can share adventures. I can share healings and miracles, you know, with people that maybe have not experienced that yet. But I'm telling you that this is a year. This is a year of acceleration. This is a year of provision. God is going to put money in your hands supernaturally, yes. And then in the natural. I'm Amen. Telling you right now. And what the Holy Spirit's been speaking to me about is to be righteous. Mm. And that means to be right.
Yes.
You know, if we're right with God, God is going to supernaturally bless us. Mm. You know, we're supposed to be calling heaven to earth, not earth to heaven.
Right.
We have to
right.
pull that stuff
yes.
down. We have
Amen.
To let that manifest. You know, God's glory, you know, manifest on earth. And so, you know, I just think it's amazing that you know, we have to have, you know, even as you guys have relationships with your husbands, that we have relationships with God.
Yes.
Oh, yes.
You know, and if you want to share even, you know, an experience that God has given to you, an encounter, you know, with the Holy Ghost that even just made you come to who you are today.
Oh, absolutely. Well, I've had several experiences with the Lord speaking to me, and
Amen.
I know that a lot of people are looking for, they want to hear God, but unfortunately we're always wanting to hear from God, but he speaks in different ways.
Yes.
So, yes, I have had. I mean, there was a time when I was single, and the Lord said to me, child, come to me. Quit looking for love in this world and rest in me. He said, do you know how much you love Drake, which is my son? And I said, yes, Lord. And he said, I love you oceans and seas more than you could ever imagine loving Drake.
Yeah.
And then I thought about my sin. I thought about my abortions. Mm-hmm. And I said, but Lord. And he said, I've already forgiven you. Just
wow.
rest in me. And that was so profound. And then there were my Jesus freak aunt called me up and told me one time, the Lord wants you to read Isaiah 26, 3 and 4. And so I was like, okay, the Lord wants me to read Isaiah 26, 3 and 4. And at the time, I was not really walking with the Lord, so I just wrote it down. Well, then when I finally went to pick up the Bible and look and see what the Lord wanted to say to me, I picked up this Bible, and it had been through a flood, so it was a little crispy. And I opened it up, and it opened up right to Isaiah 26.
Wow.
And it said, you will keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on you because he trusts in you. Trust in the Lord forever, for he is the eternal rock. And I felt hot oil go from
wow.
the top of my head to the bottom of my feet. That was amazing. That's when I looked up and I saw the hand of God come down from heaven, use my aunt, and then use my Grammy from my dad's side. My Mexican grandma, who actually is with the Lord right now, and I know she's dancing on the streets of gold with her Jesus, because she loved the Lord. And she said, then 3 days later, she walked up to me and said, Tina, the Lord wanted me to give this to you. And it was a little card that said Isaiah 26,
wow.
3 and 4. I was like, whoa. And then the night my husband and I met, the Lord said, he's here. He's here tonight. So there's been many times the Lord has spoken to me, used other people to, you know, because he uses that prophetic words. I mean, the Lord wants to communicate. He wants to talk to us. He wants us to hear from him and not always just be led by just prophecies. Because I know people that go from this prophet to that prophet to this prophet, running here and there, wanting guidance in their life. But the Holy Spirit wants to guide us, guide us to the right husband, guide us in our marriage for, you know, amazing solutions to whatever's going on. Guide us in, you know, maybe a thought or an idea that he has for us to bless us and to bless others financially. Amen. So we need to be able to listen to what the Lord is saying, on the inside right here in your belly, where it says out of your belly will flow rivers of living water.
Amen.
That's where the Holy Spirit normally speaks to us, or you can have visions and dreams also. And I did have a vision when I met my husband. This huge cross came coming out of the ground and it started lifting me up, and I was like, oh Lord, and I just bowed down. The cross went all the way up to the sky. And I was like, whoa, I'd never had a vision in my life. And I told my husband, and he goes, that's because God is going to be lifted up in our marriage. And you bowed down because you're going to be humble and you're going to allow him to do that.
That's
and I was like, whoa, okay, Lord, whatever you want to do. And so it's just exciting. You know, walking with the Lord, it's exciting when you allow the Holy Spirit to flow and let him guide your life. And, you know, you're never going to be bored when you're walking with the Lord, that's for sure.
That's powerful word. Amen. You know, and that's another thing. It's like, you know, as people will go from churches to churches or from prophets to prophets, you know, they don't even realize that really God has been trying to speak to them all along. And they're not hearing because they're out, you know, hearing from everyone else. And and I know even in my walk with God, you know, it was one of those things to where, you know, I just was like, Lord, I want to hear from you. And once I finally realized, like, all along he had been speaking to me, I'm like, oh, my gosh, he's been speaking to me forever, you know, since I was a little girl. But you know, he will bring prophets, you know, because we have to share, you know, the word. We have to, you know, share that word that God wants them to say, hey, you know what, you've been hearing God all along. You're a prophet. God's going to use you, and you've been called to the nations. And then they're, and then you know, they're like, "Well, really?" And we're going to, the prophet's going to say, "Yes," because you know you've been fighting with Satan. You know the other little, you know, person over here on this shoulder has been saying no, and you're not hearing from God. You know, no. You keep on going and falling into sin. You know, and that's how the enemy works. You know, it's he wants to bring confusion in your life. That's he wants to misdirect you into, you know, where God wants to take you. And so that's where the prophets come in, and they will prophesy, and they will say, you know, this is where you're going. This is where God wants to take you. He wants to take you into your destination. You know, so, you know, I thank God for that, you know, and I thank God that, you know, he gives us so many gifts. There's so many gifts in all of us that we don't even realize, you know, and I always share that with the people, that you have so many gifts in you that you don't even know how many gifts that are out there until God takes you, and then you start seeing the favor of God in your life. And those things, like I always say, you know what? You're a doctor. Why are you a doctor? Because God has given you healing hands, right? And you know, and sometimes, you know, you're teaching the word of God. Well, you're a teacher. Well, how? Well, because God's given you the word to teach, okay? You know, you're a pastor. Why? Because you have a flock of sheep. And you need to teach them right ways, you know, to go, you know, towards God. So, you know, these are all gifts that God has given us. Desiree has a special gift, not only with a prophetic, but also as a worshiper. So I want to know, like, were you singing, like, from the very beginning of when you, you know, as a little girl? I mean, how did you, like, come out to start worshiping?
So here's another story for you.
There we
awesome.
Go.
I love stories.
So, well, growing up in my house, so my dad sings. He's a singer, just a natural singer. So my sisters sing. And we've had they've had someone speak over their life and tell them that they're going to sing, and when they sing and when they open their mouth, not only are they going to sing and people are going to worship, but that people are going to get healed when they sing.
Amen.
So they've had visions of them singing in stadiums and just worshiping the Lord and just hundreds of people getting healed.
Amen.
So myself, I didn't really sing. I wasn't really a singer, and I love to sing. You know, there's those people that sing in the shower, and they sound great, right? So, you know, I was one of those singers that, okay, I want to sing, I want to sing, I want to sing. And so I would just practice and practice and practice and just, you know, sing worship songs. And my sisters, you know, they'd get this song. We'd get a song to practice for worship, and they just, bam, they got it, right? And I was like, oh, how could they just get it so easily, you know? And so, and I think more because I wanted it so much, you know, and I wanted it so much, and I would, okay, God, I'm going to do this, and I'm going to sing, and I'm going to make it sound great. Like, you're going to make me sound great, you know,
amen.
Because I can never do this on my own.
Yes, amen.
So I would do that. So one day there was a spot available on the worship team at church, right? Yeah. And so I told my husband, nope, I'm not going to do it. I'm not going to do it. I'm not going to do it. You know, and he's like, I'm praying. I'm praying that, you know, you're going to be on that worship team one day. So I don't know how it came about. I know he said, you know, okay, you know, when are you going to join this worship team? And I said, well, when we get a new worship leader, you know, just making something up. I didn't know what to say. And so, you know, and so at this time, our worship leader had been there for years. She'd been there for years, you know, and I was like, she's never going to leave. I said, when we get a new worship leader, I'll join. So guess what? Our worship leader stepped down.
Oh, wow.
And we got a new worship leader, and he's like, you see, God listens to me. And I was like, okay. I was like, okay, Lord, you know, so.
Yes.
I joined the team, and it's been a few years now that I've been on the team, you know, and it's amazing, you know, and I love to worship. And so I just go up there, and I'm like, okay, God, like you, it's going to be you through me to reach your people, you know, and I know worship is an important part of, you know, at the service.
Yes.
And so it's as much as the pastor comes up and speaks and gives that word, and it's so important, so is worship, you know.
Amen.
And so we come before the pastor, so we come and we break down everything, those walls that people walk in with,
yes.
You know, strongholds, people come in angry, bitter, sick, you know, and I know that we need to come and we need to bring his worship. And so I go.
That we have to claim it,
yes.
You know, and proclaim it, decree it, and declare it in the name of Jesus, that it does not matter, you know, even if we have had, you know, abuse in our life, mm-hmm. or addiction, or you know, poverty, or whatever it is, you know, we know how great our God is, you know.
That's right.
Our
yes.
God is
yes,
so
he
rich
is.
You know, and he wants us to have everything, you know. He says in Psalms 37:3-4, it says, if you trust in God, he will give you the desires of your heart.
Yes. Yeah, right.
You know, and I think with both of you guys have both experienced that, you know, through yourselves, through your relationships with your husbands, you know, and having a prayerful spouse, you know, I mean, that makes everything. And that's what I can't wait. You know, I cannot wait for that day to come for me that, you know what? I'm going to have another person, because the Lord says that it's better to have two than one,
two
right?
Than one, yes.
And so that's what I'm waiting for, and I'm waiting for God's time. You know, I'm not out there to say, "Oh, I want this man of God or I want that man of God." No, you know what? Amen. I'm out there, and God will show me. You know, he will show that man of God, this is your wife.
Yes.
This
yes.
is your better half. Or not even better half. I don't even like to say the better half, because both of you guys are made whole.
That's right.
Right?
Right.
So, you know, he will show, you know, you single people who the man or that woman of God is to be. And I want to encourage you that it says in Genesis 28:15, it says, "God is with me and will keep watch over me with care, take notice of me wherever I may go." So there's no reason for us to be lonely.
Right.
You know, when you have Jesus with you, he is all you need.
That's right.
He is all you need. Mm-hmm. You know, and being married, you know, I'm sure that, you know, it's a time, I believe that as your guys as, you know, family, you have family, you know, and your children. Mm-hmm. And so it's kind of like, you know, I believe that God will give you that time. Or, you know, you guys could even talk about, you know, how do you strategize your day? You know, like, how do you even spend your time with God? Mm-hmm. You know, because I know that you have two daughters, mm-hmm. you know, and your son, but, you know, your two daughters are young and, you know, and they're skaters, they're ice skaters. And so mm-hmm. she's, you know, taking them, and even though you have, you know, in-home school, but how do you find the time for you to spend your time with the Lord, either in worship or through prayer or reading the Bible? I mean, share to the people,
okay.
How do you do that so that maybe, you know, they can understand how to manage, you know, their time with God? Mm-hmm.
Well, first of all, we like to have worship at our home most of the time. I mean,
good.
If we could have 24-hour worship in our home, we have that plane. All
wow,
the time,
because awesome.
First yeah. of all, that sets the tone in the home.
Amen.
Okay, it does.
Yes,
it changes the whole atmosphere.
Yes, it does.
Usually for me, morning time when I have my morning coffee, especially out in my garden, because we have waterfalls and everything. Now, right now, it's been raining, so I haven't been out there. But I just, you know, you have to. It has to become just part of your day, because it's so easy to, especially as a mother, to hit the ground running. There's always something that's going to come up,
yes.
right? But the one thing that convicted me was when I was, you know, on my phone a lot, and then I was like, you know, Lord, am I spending as much time with you as I am on Facebook? And that was a big, big conviction
oh,
for me.
Boy.
So I try, and trust me, I'm human, we all are, but I try to give God more time than I do to Facebook.
Yes,
and
amen.
Sometimes that means just putting your phone away.
Yes.
You know, right now I'm actually reading through the Bible from cover to cover on my own. I've always, you know, I've done Bible studies. I've been in church for many, many years. But I have never literally read the Bible from cover to cover.
Wow, good.
And so I've been doing that, and I love it. I love, you know, just going through it on my own, letting the Holy Spirit lead and really just chewing on the
yes,
word.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
Yes.
And not just reading like, oh, I'm just going to get this done. But I did not want to stand before the Lord one day and say, Lord, you know, I'm so sorry that I didn't have time to read from cover to cover. Mm. You know, I only picked the New Testament or the Old Testament or this or that or what I was interested in. But I want to hear the whole word of God.
Amen.
So that's what I've been doing. Worshiping, you know, we dance in our home. That's a wonderful thing to do. And just always having us, you know, having worship music on.
Amen.
You know, Paul will come home sometime. He's like, hey, what's going on? Well, you know, the girls and I will be having something's going on. And he's like, hey, we need to put some worship music on.
Wow, that's
and that
good.
Just puts peace in the home.
Wow, I love it.
Soaking music when the children are sleeping. I love, you know, when we've gone through some things with my daughter before when she's being bullied. For the whole month, it seemed like I was in ER. And the doctors couldn't find anything wrong, I would put soaking music on because I knew it was a spiritual attack.
Yes,
oh, yeah.
But, you know, so there's things that we can do to keep that. And praying in tongues.
Yes. Yes.
You know, the Bible says to pray without ceasing. And I realize we can't do that with our verbal mouth with our mind.
Right.
We can't pray without ceasing,
yeah.
but we can speak in tongues
yes.
all the time
yes,
while we're
can.
Driving, whatever, to build up our inner man.
Amen.
And I know my husband does that even more than I do. He's been speaking in tongues for, gosh, since he was
20. Well, it says, I mean, it does say in the Bible that, you know, to pray in the spirit.
Right.
You know, and all the time it
yes.
says, you know, because the enemy, you know, he hears all the words that we say.
That's
all
right.
the words that are coming out of our mouth. And so, you know, only God can hear you, you know, speak in that heavenly language.
Mm-hmm.
And so I want to encourage all of you that, you know, if you don't have the baptism of the Holy Spirit and speaking in tongues, I would say get it.
Yes.
You know, that should be one of the things that you want, because it is very powerful, especially in the time of prayer
yes.
and in a time of need for anything. You know, I mean, you can even sing in the spirit,
yes.
you know, and so this is, I just want to say this about that is because I remember when I was in China and I was actually with Pastor Joshua and he was doing his conference, and we had like over 5,000 people there showing up every day for like 7 days, and they had programs in the morning. Programs
wow.
then in the afternoon, and then everyone would come together in the evening. And so I remember they had these classes that were set up for, you know, different instructors, and for whatever reason the worship leader didn't show up, and so they're like looking for someone to, you know, lead the class, and I'm like, I'm not a worshiper. I mean, like, you know, I mean, like, I'll worship God, but, you know, I'm not a worshiper, you know. And I'm like, oh, Holy Ghost, really? You're gonna put me in this place? But see, the thing was that he was stretching me.
Yeah.
He was stretching me, okay? And so right away, the Lord gave me the words. He's like, look up what worship is. And I'm like, I looked it up, so I shared it. I had a translator because everyone's Chinese, you know, they don't speak English and they don't understand English. So they're, you know, the translator's, you know, translating for me. And then the Holy Ghost said, I want you to sing in the spirit. And I'm like, oh, I can do that. I can sing in the spirit, right? And so I started telling everyone, and we started, everyone just started singing in the spirit.
Yeah.
Oh,
wow.
My gosh, what happened next? People started getting healed. The Holy Ghost
Amen.
Started telling me, he goes, there's someone that just had some sinus, you know, create a miracle, or ears, or cataracts, or knees. My translator's knee got healed. She just started
Amen.
Screaming. She's like, I'm healed. God just healed me. And I'm like, oh, my gosh, like, praise God. I mean, it was a supernatural
That's
experience
awesome.
As I was leading this worship. You know, and again, I wasn't a worship, you know, person. But glory to God that, see, he will give you the gifts.
Yes.
The
yes.
special
yes.
gifts that you think that you don't have, he will give them to you so that,
right.
so his glory, you know, he can, you know, so that we can give him the glory. Anyway, that happened too. I had to do two sessions in a row, and people were coming, like they were like they were hearing this beautiful music, and they were coming into
wow.
our and into our room, and they were getting healed. I couldn't believe all the healing miracles that God did, you know.
Wow,
and I wasn't
man.
Even laying hands on anyone. That was the Holy Ghost, you know, because you know God gives us our hands, you know, of course, you know, so because he says to anoint the people and touch
right.
them, right? Not. I'm one of those people. I love to touch people. You know, I just want them to feel the fire of God, you know, because I have the fire of God in me. But
Amen.
but when it's a supernatural experience like that, where the glory of God is in this room and the Shekinah glory, I mean, it's like the most amazing experience.
Yes,
because,
it is.
You know, people get healed. People get touched. People have an encounter with God. And that is what the worship is about. It's
yes.
about, you know, that encounter with the Holy Ghost, you know, and I just love it so much. I mean, I just love God so much. But I want you to share, sweetie, you know, like even maybe I know you've had some encounters with God when you have been just laid out, you know, either praying or in that time of just in his presence. If you can share with the audience, you know, what God did to you and how he touched you.
Amen. So just recently, I want to say in this last year, I've had so many things happen, you know, and in my health, you know, so So when things happen to you in your health, you it's not only you that go through it, your family goes through it too. So just recently, I've suffered from having diabetes. Mm-hmm. And so my eyesight just completely went. So I had no eyesight whatsoever. My left eye went out, then the right eye went out, and I was just completely blinded, like nothing. I couldn't see anything. And so I had my daughters helping me. I had my husband helping me around. And it's just like the most horrible feeling that you can feel. Like not like from being able to see and do things on your own to doing nothing on your own. Like not you can't even walk, you know, to the kitchen or anywhere, you know.
Right.
And so it was a really, really tough time. And so at this point, we were having women's group. And I didn't even want to go to women's group. I'm like, I can't see. How am I going to get to church? I don't want to sit. I don't want to fall. I don't want to, you know.
Right.
And so we were reading on the Sacred Slow. We were reading that book in women's group about the Sacred Slow. And so God was just showing me just, okay, I need to slow down. I need to take it easy. I just need to sit before the Lord and do nothing and say nothing and just sit. So I would sit, like my kids would be at school, my husband would be at work, and you know, you want to be that strong mom, and you know, you don't want to cry in front of the kids, and you know, you want to make sure everything's good. And so everybody would be gone. I would have my family coming, taking the kids to school, my husband at work. And so I'd be home and I'd just wake up early and sit there and just sit there and and just cry like, God, you know, I know you're here with me and I know, you know, that this is going to get better. But at the time and at the moment when you're going through things, like you just feel like it's never going to end, you know.
Yes.
It feels like years and moments, you know. And so I just sat before the Lord, and sometimes you just need to sit.
Yes, amen.
You just need to sit and say nothing and just be in his presence, you know? And so that's what I did. I sat and I was there in his presence, and I just soaked it all in, and I just cried before him, and I just felt him, you know? I just felt him all over me, and it's like, okay, God, this is what you want me to do. You want me to sit and do nothing, because we're busy. We get busy, and life is so busy, and we have children, and we have school, and we have practice, and we have church, and we have ministries. And even though those are all good things, and, you know, we do them for the kingdom and for the glory of God, sometimes we need to take that break.
Yeah.
And there's that rest that we need to have, you know? And so I guess I didn't do it on my own. So God said, okay, pump the brakes, you know? And so I was here and I was at this point. And so I would just sit before him. And so as days would go by, you know, I'd hear my husband and he would go off and he'd be home from work helping out. And he would just go into another room and just cry, you know, like it's so hard, you know, and pray and okay, God, and we believe for the healing. We believe for the healing. And so little by little, my vision started coming back, you know. And so now I have full vision. Like my vision is back and I can see. And I wake up every morning and I'm so grateful and I'm so thankful to the Lord. And so the first thing I do when I wake up is like, thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, God. I love you so much. Thank you for giving me another day, you know. Thank you for giving me another day. And I'm able to see, you know. I still have my glasses and it's not 20/20, but I can see, you know. And I'm good.
So is that from the diabetes then?
So that was from the diabetes. So from having diabetes, I guess it affects different parts of your body. It can affect your feet with neuropathy, your eyesight, just a bunch of different things, your blood. Some people go on dialysis because of it. And so I'm not claiming any of those things.
We
don't claim any of those things. And so I got my vision back. And so the doctor's telling me just to, you know, eat better, be healthy, do the right things, exercise. And, you know, I was doing a lot of those things and I was like, God, why did this happen? You know, and sometimes we don't understand why and we don't know why, but we just, you know, that time that I had with him just to sit before him and alone was just so amazing, you know, just to be able to soak in his presence.
And I believe that too. I believe that God was, you know, sometimes what happens to us is that, you know, we have this problem or an issue with our knees or, you know, eyes, whatever the case is. And sometimes God will use that for you You know, and I believe that he was using that for you to rest in him, because
yes.
you're always going all the time, especially with your kids. But also, too, I've seen it to the other point where I had to go into the hospital for my knee, but really wasn't about my knee. It was about someone I was meeting in the hospital to pray over, you know?
Yes.
So every time that something like that happens to us in our bodies, you have to know that, wait a minute, God's going to do something with that. You know, he has to use us as a sacrifice, you know, kind of, you know, so that we can get to that person. You know, I mean, I remember even being going to social services, and, you know, I never thought in my whole life I would have to go and claim social services, you know, but what it was is that God, there was three women, there was two women that came to the Lord to know Jesus,
Amen.
And another woman who I prophesied over and said, hey, God wants you back. He wants you to come back to his kingdom. And that lady, she was just like, okay, you know, because it was like, God will take you to places where
yes.
you need to go for him.
Right. Yes.
You know, and I remember even walking, like I would walk, and I'm in the city of Orange. I used to live right across the street from Angel Stadium. And there was a gym, there was like three gyms in my complex, and the Lord said, no, go for a walk today. I'm like, what? Go for a walk. I'm like, all right. So I go for a walk. Next thing you know, I'm traveling down the riverbed, okay? And I'm like looking. I'm like, oh, my gosh. Like I'm seeing, you know, like homeless people underneath, you know, underneath the in the riverbed the river. There. You know, there's, what do you call those? Cross.
The wash.
It's like a, but there's like a bridge. Okay, so the people are underneath the bridge. They're living underneath the bridge. And so I'm walking, and, you know, I'm just praying, you know, the whole time. I'm just praying, and then I meet this guy, and he starts, you know, talking. We start sharing, and I just, you know, like the Holy Ghost just, like, says, you know, like, tell him that I love him. Tell him that I'm waiting for him, and just, you know, tell him these things. And so I start sharing with him, and then all of a sudden I'm like, I'm so sorry, but I don't have any water. Like, I didn't even have any water with me to carry out. Mm-hmm. I didn't have any money with me. I didn't have anything. But what he said to me, he said, but what you have given me is better than water.
That's right.
Is better than any food. He goes, you just blessed me with Amen. That word.
Amen.
And I was like, OMG. Like, that was, I was like beside myself. Like, not only, you know, like, he touched me. You
yes.
know what I mean?
Yes.
It's like
yes.
he touched me. And, right. you know, and that's what God does with us. He uses us, you know, and sometimes, you know, we think that it's about us. And it's not even about us. It's because God wants to bless us back.
Right.
He just wants to bless us back. And so I want to encourage all of you out there that, you know, to sow your seed, you know, to sow your time, sow your prayers, sow your faith, sow your hope into people, you know, because it's a blessing. And you know, like that with, you know, that with even with that thing that happened with me, how I was so blessed by it, you know. And you know, you think sometimes that, oh, you're going to go out there and you're going to go minister and da, 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 you know, and people are coming back and ministering to you.
That's right.
Because, you know,
right.
it's like you have one finger, but you got four fingers pointing back to you, you know, and God wants to use you. You just have to know, we just all have to be humble and walk in that humility. But I want to encourage all of you, if you want to sow any sort of donations to Vision TV, you can write to Vision TV. The address is 15361 Brookhurst Street, and it's Suite 212 in Westminster, California. And I'm sorry, but I don't know the zip code. But again, it's Vision TV, 15361 Brookhurst. You guys can text me, and you know, some of those who know my phone number, 949-378-7940, you can call me. We will pray for you. Mm-hmm. We don't have our phones open right now, but eventually these prayer lines will be open, because, you know, we want to pray for you.
Yeah.
We want you to come to the TV station. Our doors are open to invite all of you, men, women, children, the elderly, you know, the disabled. You know, we believe in the power of God for healing. We believe in the Holy Spirit. We believe that Jesus is the Son of God. We believe
yes.
that Jesus loves you.
Yes,
we
yes,
love
amen.
You so much And, you know, we just want to offer that to you. We want to offer you. It's a free gift. God wants to give you a free gift. That's his salvation. And when you have that free gift, your life will forever be changed. As you have been a witness to these testimonies of what God has done in their lives. You know, you can be a murderer. You can be a rapist. You can be, you know, a drug addict. You can be an alcohol. Whatever it is. You know what? That's lies from the enemy. That is not your destination.
That's
is
right.
To be stuck in that. Your destination is to be stuck with God.
Amen.
You know, and to
yes.
serve God and to help other people. And so I want to encourage all of you that whatever is on, you know, in your life, come here. We will bless you. We will help you. The doors are open for you to share. You know, and we love you. We love you so much. And Jesus loves you even more.
Yes,
he just
does.
Loves
yes,
you so
he does.
Much. So we thank you for tuning in on Vision TV. We thank you for watching Overcome by Love, Women on Fire. Please share this. Please share the videos. You know, and just we're going to be praying for you that God is going to bless you
yes.
with beyond measure, okay,
amen,
which means it's
amen.
Unlimited. You just don't even know what God has for you. So anyway, we're praying for you. God bless each and every one of you. We love you. Good night.
Good night.
All right. That was awesome.